Not sure if anyone has mentioned this, but hey, Zion Williamson makes his NBA debut
tonight. What channel's it on, Rach?
I'm going to tell you that the Pelicans host the Spurs right here on ESPN. Zion is expected to be in the starting lineup, but they will monitor his minutes. Brian, do you like New Orleans' game plan for Zion? Because there was some back and forth over whether he was going to start.
Okay. One thing I'm going to give the Pelicans huge credit on here. They know this is a big event. Mm-hmm. They told us several days ago, Zion is going to come back on Wednesday. They allowed ESPN to switch the schedule to make sure it could be on national television.
Yep.
Yes, I have a vested interest in it. I work for ESPN. But as an NBA fan, I'm very happy to see it. They are going to start him tonight because it is the right thing to do for the game. Then Zion has to achieve on his own. But they recognize, other teams are like, oh no, game time decision, blah, blah, blah. The league needs Zion right now, and New Orleans and the Pelicans organization is really trying to make it happen, and it's good for their fans too. And I am excited about him, Tracy, because in the preseason, when LeBron was a rookie, he was not good in the preseason. Mm-hmm. I was nervous about LeBron's first game. Now, he was awesome.
Right.
But part of the reason he was awesome is because the preseason was shaky. Zion's preseason
was incredible.
Was one of the greatest in the history of rookies in the game.
Wow.
So while I recognize he is coming off a knee injury, unlike LeBron, who was fully healthy, and he's probably only going to play, you know, 15 or 20 minutes.
Is Zion really still coming off a knee injury?
Well, he's healthy.
Coming off a knee injury. About
did you see this man in Madison Square Garden just mm-hmm. vertically put it between his legs? Are you
know,
kidding
I don't
me?
Go over the top a lot. I am really, really excited to see Zion.
He's tonight, I think he's going to have an amazing night. One, the adrenaline is going to be flowing, and we know as great players, when that adrenaline is flowing like that and he's eager to get out there, he's going to be jumping higher than everybody, which he already does. He's going to be faster. He's going to be stronger. Like, he's going to have an incredible night. And I think it's going to be easy for him because of the style of play they play. They're one of the fastest paced teams in the NBA.
And don't you think they've got some plays ready? Don't you think they've got a pet play ready for him?
Just a lob to get him comfortable and build his confidence. But he's going to be amazing tonight.
It's interesting. Our Adrian Wojnarowski reporting that the Pelicans have pulled back from any trade phone calls and that they're thinking, hey, this isn't the time when they had that 13-game losing streak. They've been winning games. Zion's coming back. Let's make that playoff push.
They also have, you know, a favorable schedule.
So we'll see what happens. And the Pelicans, of course, now not that far off from the number 8 seed, only 3.5 games back. So all of that excitement that you saw in that piece from fans, you could see some of that playoff excitement this year. And I mentioned at the top of the show, Adrian Wojnarowski reporting that the Pelicans have made it clear they're pulling back from any trade talks. They're going to use this team and go for it if things stay the way they've been these last few weeks.
In fact, I've heard that in the talks that they've had, they've been looking to acquire.
Ooh.
Players like, you know, maybe not a big time player, but like if they're going to add something, maybe add a veteran,
right?
Because they are a really young team, and that's why I can't, even though their schedule's favorable, I can't quite, without having seen Zion, bring myself to say they're going to do it because they are so young. They have experienced guys, but you'd be relying on guys who'd never been there before. So that's, I can't quite get myself to say that.
I like what Brandon Ingram and Lonzo Ball have been doing lately.
Oh, yeah. I definitely think they have a great chance of making the playoffs if Zion can continue to stay healthy. Reason being is these guys have been playing, I think Ingram and Lonzo having a breakout year. And you have J.J. Redick, who's a sniper on this team. You add somebody like Zion, who I think could be a 20-point scorer. Like, you adding another 20-point scorer. So you got Drew Holiday, who's averaging 20. You have Ingram, who's averaging 25. Lonzo is putting up nice numbers this year. And you add a 20-point scorer. Absolutely, they can make the playoffs this year with him being healthy.
But there's a bunch of teams around them that could potentially add pieces as well.
Right.
Portland, you know, potentially getting some good news. I'd like to see where everybody is in about 3-4 weeks.
Mm-hmm.
I know that the question is being asked today.
The question is being asked today because they don't have 3-4 weeks to the trade deadline.
Right, but
so
I want to see. I want to see where everything
going
happens
for it or not.
Right.
I want to see what happens at the deadline, and I want to see how Zion looks for 3 or 4 weeks.
Right.
I'm not worried about how he's going to look. I am worried about like what other teams would do in terms of the pieces that they add to their roster. That could potentially, you know, hurt a team like New Orleans. So we'll see.
We'll see. I was just trying to look up J.J. Redick's quote to Zion at the beginning of the season.
Don't mess up
my playoff streak.
13 seasons.
J.J. has made the playoffs every season, and he would like that to continue. Thanks for watching ESPN on YouTube. For more sports highlights and analysis, be sure to download the ESPN app. And for live streaming sports and premium content, subscribe to ESPN+.